I'm Dr. Rosa Williams, Professor of Astronomy at Columbus State University, and along with Dr. Kimberly Shaw, Professor of Physics, we'd like to present Reimagining Astronomy with Open Educational Resources and Active Learning Techniques. We've applied this to the class Astronomy 1105, Descriptive Astronomy, the Solar System at Columbus State University. So first, the purpose of this class transformation, it started with a primary thrust at using an open educational resource textbook, in our case, OpenStax Astronomy. But we expanded it in order to increase the amount of non-lecture engagement and face-to-face discussion there was in the course. So less of the sage on the stage and more direct interaction in class. We added to that the concept of a semester group project in which they could apply their learning that they had picked up during the semester to a real world problem in which they could conceive of scientific exploration of other planets. So the metrics by which we measured how well we did with this included the astronomy diagnostic test version 2.0, the students' test score progression through the last 3 years and their class grades, 3 peer instruction observations by Dr. Kimberly Shaw as I was teaching the class, and a student satisfaction survey at the end of the course. We also took note of student responses and satisfaction throughout the course and compared it to previous courses. So our overall class transformation plan was to adopt the OpenStax Astronomy textbook and have pre-class reading quizzes assigned to the students so that they were encouraged to read and review the material in advance. In the past, our surveys of the class students have shown the prices of textbooks and the timing of financial aid meant that many students were not getting their textbooks until late into the class, or indeed not at all. And so we hoped that this would correct that problem. As I said, we expanded the program to increase the non-lecture varieties of engagement. So that included using existing lecture tutorials and similar group exercises throughout the class and developing new tailored open educational resources tutorials for them to use. Some of those examples are in your handouts. We had a number of clicker response questions, think, pair, share, and individual responses, students during class. And we provided them with a lot of online links to and played in class, animations, short videos, interactive websites, things where they could get hands-on with the material. And finally, as I said, the semester group project was meant to use this material in a realistic scenario. The scenario in this case had the students group up in groups of 3 or 4 and address the question of where we should send our next space probes and what kind of mission should it be within the solar system, what would bring us the best scientific returns and best provide good payback to society for the money spent. The program was designed so that they turned in material at 3 different stages. A first rough idea stage due at the second week of class, a second rough draft where they reconceived the whole project from the beginning. The idea of the rough idea was just to get them started thinking about it. The rough draft was an actual proposal of what they meant to do. They would have feedback on both of these and put those together into the third final proposal that was due at the end of the semester. So as far as metrics go, we used the astronomy diagnostic test. All students in the course took the pretest, 39 out of 40 students. Only 27 out of 40 students took the post-test. There was large absenteeism on the last day when the post-test was given, an oversight on our part. And also some students expressed extreme reluctance to take this post-test. The pretest average was 34%, which is consistent with our expectations. The post-test average is 45.5%, again, consistent with expectations and showing roughly a 2-point improvement out of the scores that are available to them. So that showed us the learning that they were getting was commensurate to what you would get in similar courses with no drop in quality. Likewise, we compared their test scores to the test scores for the past 3 years. We found that in some cases, the test scores improved. In other cases, particularly the second test, they declined, which I attribute personally to trying to cover too much material. And the final exam, finally similar on that. The final class grades were improved by about a couple of percentage points from the past 3 years. The reading quizzes, students had done similar quizzes in previous courses as post-lecture quizzes. Now these were preparatory quizzes, and yet they did not drop down in their understanding. So the reading quizzes, they did just as well as they did when they took those quizzes after lectures. There were far fewer withdrawals from the course than over the past 3 years. So overall, that comes to no drop in overall performance and really a modest improvement. Peer observation showed that the students were clearly engaged, although there were some groups that had trouble maintaining focus when doing independent work in their group interactions. The follow-up discussions of those tutorials were extremely helpful. And overall, we think we need to emphasize this point more, use more of the course time for class discussion and allowing students to process the material. On our student survey, we found that 25 out of 31 students who answered the survey did all or most of the advanced readings, which is a very considerable improvement about, and the reason we determine this program in the first place. For in-class engagement, 27 out of 31 rated the material as interesting and said that the in-class activities helped them to learn material, so there was highly increased enthusiasm. The student projects, which I expected to be largely panned by the students, actually were considered quite satisfactory by about 2/3 of the class, 22 of 31, an interesting way of using what we've learned. Class satisfaction, as reported by the students, was high. 25 out of 31 rated it as excellent or good as how the class was taught, and 27 out of those 31 said they learned a lot or a good deal within the class. So overall, having an open educational resource text and quizzes to prompt its use improves student preparation. The various active learning techniques that we adopted, such as the group tutorials, in-class questions with clicker responses, and discussion post-tutorials, increased student confidence in how they were doing, their engagement with the class, and clearly very much their enthusiasm. The student group projects, likewise, were surprisingly well received, considering that in the past, students had rated group projects as among their least favorite things to do. We did not see any significant drop in student scores, and in fact, maybe some modest improvement, and we did see much higher reported student satisfaction. So overall, moving in this direction seems to be a very promising way to teach astronomy, and indeed, we've continued using these open educational resource materials and teaching using these techniques for the fall of 2020 and spring of 2021 semesters of this class. And I think we are beginning to get the hang of it. Thank you, and I appreciate your attention.